Australia versus Samoa this weekend. The World Cup final. Man, it's going to be an epic match. Who do I think is going to win? Stick around to the end and I'll let you know. But first of all, I just want to let you know why I think this is going to be the last World Cup Rugby League final in the history of ever, of mankind. The reason is because Jesus Christ is due to return at any moment. Let me tell you why. The Bible is full of prophecy. Prophecy is stuff that is prophetic word that's going to happen in the future. Lots of prophecy has come true over the years. One prophecy that I want to bring to you right here, right now, which is a huge sign, huge proof that the Bible is true, that the Bible is real, other than the obvious signs. But this main one is the nation of Israel. I don't know if you know where that is. It's in the Middle East. And it wasn't a nation until for a long time. It was wiped out. It was no longer a nation. And in 1948, it became a nation once again. The Bible foretold that that would happen. The Bible foretold that it would be destroyed and then Israel will become a nation again. The Bible said that when this happens, the generation that sees this happen will also be the generation that's still alive when the return of Jesus Christ happens. So we add it up, 1948 up until now, 2022, that's 74 years. In the Bible, it's in the book of Psalms, it says that a generation of life is usually between 70 to 80 years, so that we are smack bang in the middle of that timeline. The other reasons I believe that Jesus Christ could come back at any moment is because we are stepping closer and closer into a one world order, new world order. The one world religion, the World Economic Forum, I don't know if you've heard of them, check them out, but they are evil, just people that are in control of the world. They got a lot of wealth, they got control of just stuff that blows your mind, that is just out of this world. But these are the people that are going to set up the one world order, one world religion. The Bible says this would happen. The Bible says that there will be a one world government, that we will all have the mark of the beast, a chip in our hand or our forehead, that you can't buy or sell without it. People are already getting conditioned to holding your phone to pay, holding your hand to pay. So most people, if you ask them, they wouldn't care if they had a chip here to make life easy. We all want life easy. We just go, boop. They wouldn't even care. Most people that haven't heard this word, that haven't heard about the Bible, they pay no attention to God. This day and age, especially in the Western world, we don't need God because we've got everything sorted. Here in Australia, we don't need God. If I don't have a job, if I'm going through struggles, I got the dole. Housing commission, I got it sorted. The Bible says that in the last days, men will be lovers of themselves. We see that. Look at the genre of music, hip hop. I mean, the genre of music, drill rap. Lovers of themselves. You can't say they're not. Look at Drake. All these other groups, drill groups, you know, it's all about me and what I'm going to do to you, and I'm violent, and I got all this money, man, and you know, don't mess with me and my crew, and all this stuff. It's all me, you know, it's all the same old. The Bible says that there'll be people, they'll be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, proud, arrogant, all that. We can see those characteristics everywhere these days. The Bible says in Matthew, the book of Matthew, you must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour that you don't expect. If you're not right with Jesus Christ, you can get right with Jesus Christ right here, right now. If you know Jesus Christ, but you're backslidden, God has mercy for you in grace. It says in the Bible that God's mercy renews every morning. Right now, just cry out to God, accept Jesus Christ, say, I'm a sinner. I confess that I am a sinner, that I need Jesus Christ to be my Lord and Savior. May I be a new creation and be born again. Confess that Jesus died, that you believe he died, that he rose again 3 days later. And the Bible says that you will be saved. Repent and be born again. Repent means turn away. You're living this way, you're living the same way of the world, the drinking and the alcohol and the smoking and the sex outside of marriage and all this stuff. Stop doing that stuff because it's all sin, man. Read the Bible, it shows you what sin is and what sin does. In the end, sin leads to death. my father and grandfather, both of them 50 years old, both of them lived a lifestyle of sin, of alcoholism, and all this sort of stuff. I was on the same track, but Jesus Christ set me free. I'm no longer an alcoholic. I'm no longer a pothead smoking weed and running away from my problems anymore. I faced my problems face on because Jesus Christ has my back, because there is more than this life to look forward to. There is hope in what Jesus Christ has for us. I'm telling you right now, my friend, get your heart right with Jesus Christ. If you're backslidden, come back, man. God says that he's married to the backslider. And you know when you got Jesus Christ in your conscience, you know when you're living in sin, man. But turn away from it. It's not worth it. At the end of the day, it leads to nothing but death. And Jesus could come back at any moment, or we can die. We don't know how long we got left. So, yeah, the game this weekend, lots of alcohol, lots of partying. All that sort of stuff, you know, good on ya. But at the end of the day, man, it can lead to death. This sinful lifestyle of drunkenness and revelry, and it usually leads to sex outside of marriage and jumping in the car and going for a drunk drive and then boom, smash into a pole and didn't see that coming. But that's where the alcohol takes you, man. Dutch courage. So just give it a rest. Give your heart to Jesus Christ. Enjoy the game sober. And who do I think will win? It's very hard for me to say, but I'm going for Australia, obviously. Do I think they'll win? I'm very 50-50. If they played like they did against the Kiwis, there's no way they deserve to win. They didn't even deserve to win that game. But come on, let's go Kangaroos. Add a car for a hat trick. Maybe that's all we need. 18-16. Good on you, Samoa, for making it. God bless. Get your heart right with Jesus Christ. He's coming back soon, man. Don't miss the ark. Jesus is coming back soon. Thanks for watching.